Hey guys, welcome back. It's me, Rajan Sharma. I'm back with a brand new video. So guys, in this tutorial, I'm gonna complete the part that I left in my previous tutorial of uploading stories. Understand? So this is part two of story functionality. So make sure you subscribe our channel and press the bell icon so you will never miss any update. And in case guys, if you want source code, then you can join the membership of our channel. It will be available for the channel members. Understand? And now we can proceed. So right set post URI, and there is going to be downloads URI dot to string, and then after this guys need to write story member dot set URL, and now we don't have any URL, and then story member dot set time end. So that is going to be time end, then again story member dot set caption already done, set UID, and that is going to be current UID, and then story member dot set time upload. So we will upload the current time, understand? And now I think set URL, set name, something what is left, set name, name, set URL, set time and set time upload UID, almost everything is done. Yeah, so guys, now we can do one thing is write string, that is key for the real-time database, and here you have to write story reference user story. Actually we need all story, yes, dot push dot get key, and then all story. You know guys, now let me explain you that here what actually we are doing. So guys, we will save that story in two references, understand? And first one will be for all the stories that will display on the fragment 4, understand? And second reference will be for the particular user's story. So it will save the stories inside user ID child node, understand? So it will show the stories of a particular user, and in the first reference it will save all the first story, I mean the last story that user will upload will be show there, understand? So when you will done it, when you will do that thing, so you will be able to see in real-time database how it is looking, then you can understand more easily, understand? So for now guys, what you have to do is you can write string key, and that's this time guys we will write user story dot push dot get key semicolon, and then guys here you have to write user story dot child, and that is going to be key that we are generating above here, and then set value that will be member story member semicolon, understand? So let me comment something, user story, and this one will be all story F4 fragment 4 that will appear in fragment 4, understand? And here you can see guys that I will not create any kind of you know, I will directly write all story, then dot child, that will be current UID. So you can see that it will overwrite the data again and again whenever you will upload some new story, so it will overwrite that data in real-time database, understand? And then after this we can make the progress bar dot to set visibility gone, and above here you have to make the progress bar visible, set visibility visible, and in story here you need to make it invisible. Invisible, done. Now go back story activity, and now guys I think almost everything is correct, and now after this it's time to show a toast message that it's successful, story loaded and story uploaded, that's okay. Now progress bar is invisible, I think. Now what's next? So guys, now after this we need to implement on start, and why we need to implement, because you guys can see that here we are saving the username and the URL of the profile. So now you guys, now you can understand that we are not retrieving that data anywhere in this activity. So now it's time to retrieve that data, understand. So simply write on start, or instead of this on start, you can do one thing is we can go in this ask activity, because I think that we are definitely retrieving that data. So for this, you can simply copy this from here, go back in this. So guys, those people who came first time to this channel and don't know about all this stuff that I'm copying and pasting all this stuff, so you guys can do is watch this playlist from beginning and you will understand everything from the scratch. Understand, everything is quite simple, there is nothing to worry about. All you need to do is follow my previous tutorials and then you will be able to learn these things. Control plus C, and then it will be easy for you to understand. So guys, now we will implement on start, control plus B, and that's okay. Change the activity and then it will be fine, and remove these two fields from here. So guys, that's all you have to do, understand. So you can see that when the activity will start, so we will retrieve that data, name and URL of the user, see, and when it is retrieved successfully, then we will be able to save that data here. See, that is our story. So now guys, the story upload is successfully done, understand. And so guys, that is enough for this video. In next tutorial, we are going to work on the story retrieving, understand. So we will retrieve the story in fragment 4, and also you will be able to see the stories of a user when you will click on that particular item, understand. So guys, that's all for this tutorial. So I hope you guys like this video. Please like, share and subscribe my channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon so you will never miss any update. Thank you for watching.